Dr. G. Balamurugan, Associate Professor and Head, Department of Geology, School of Earth Sciences, Central University of Tamil Nadu. He was Associate Professor, Center for Geoinformatics, Jamsetji Tata School of Disaster Management. The Center for Geoinformatics made significant contribution towards curriculum and infrastructure development, teaching, research and extension activities. He had developed new courses for MSc, MPhil and PhD programs in school as well as for institute. Established an infrastructure facilities in the institute right from the base, including space, lab setup as co-coordinator of UGC, DRS. He had done his PhD in topic of remote sensing GIS and modeling for characterizing the fractured aquifer system in Hosur region, Tamil Nadu, India, at Department of Earth Sciences, IIT Bombay.
Okay, thank you very much. Very good evening, all of you. Firstly, I thank to NIH directors and other scientists and colleagues who provide me the opportunity to share my experience and my learning in the provided esteemed event. They have organized more than 20 topics they have selected, out of which I am talking today about innovative geospatial and AI application in WASH sector. See, what WASH means, you know that, water and sanitation hygiene. So basically water source, first I am talking about the geospatial technology, then move to groundwater potential mapping, the different methodology has been adopted in the study, results and conclusion, the way forward. So in general, water resources is available plenty. If you are looking at the entire globe, almost more than 70% of area is filled with water, you can say that. It has the ocean, lake and other reservoirs, and out of which 3% only suitable for drinking water. Out of which 3%, only 1% is surface water and 0.some% in the subsurface, that means groundwater. So the fresh water availability on the entire globe, we can say that 2.7%. So in this situation, the mapping of water resources and its sustainability development are in an important aspect, because it is that water resources used to extract more in the agriculture activity, industrial activity and other domestic purpose. The main causes of this kind of exploitation of groundwater or surface water, population growth in a particular region. So therefore, very extensive hydrogeological investigations are required to thoroughly understand a water and a groundwater condition in a particular region, to delineate this kind of especially the water sources, required geospatial technology, artificial intelligence and machine learning. So that upcoming slides, I will discuss about the geospatial technology, artificial intelligence and machine learning in the part of this presentation. So remote sensing, GIS and GPS consist of this, we called as a geospatial technology. These three tools are powerful tools and serve, it helps and supports various studies and also carried out different applications across the globe and a different part of the country. So what is geospatial technology? The remote sensing. See, remote sensing is nothing but without any physical contact, we are acquiring the information. So for the best example is our human eye. So human eyes are extracting the information or observe the information or watching the information without any physical contact. For example, we are looking at moon without any physical contact. We are looking at different stars without any physical contact. So without any physical contact, if you are acquiring the information, that is called remote sensing. We can be able to see it's a different kind of orbital remote sensing satellite over here. Indian satellite, European satellite, USA satellite, China satellite, Japan satellite, Australia satellite, Indian satellite. So every country having their own satellite. Main purpose of this satellite is, one is Earth observation. Second one is communication satellite and weather forecasting satellite. Third one is global positioning system, GPS or GNSS, Global Navigation Satellite System. So geographical information. So geographical information, that abbreviation of GIS, the GIS is capturing, storing, and manipulating the information or the data with the help of geographical coordinate system. So with the help of or with the coordinate real world system, that is called GIS. So global navigation satellite, which is supposed to identify the very precise location as well as altitude. For example, there are two different GNSS devices are there. One is handheld GPS, another one is DGPSS. The handheld GPSS helping to identify the latitude, longitude. Differential GPS, that is DGPS, helps to measure the very precise, the millimeter altitude variation. That's why they are measuring the Mount Everest very easily and very quickly with the help of a differential GPS system. Geostatistics also part of the geospatial technology. Why we include here? Different statistics methods which supports as well as analyze the different variables to obtain the very precise information of the particular study. For example, in this case, groundwater study, somebody has been used for mineral exploration, diamond exploration, gold exploration, and other studies. Even that human aspect also. I love to share that WASH, a different kind of epidemics spread, how it spread, waterborne diseases, like that. So this is the Earth observation satellite. Normally, Earth observation satellite orbiting from north to south. It is not the exact north to south. Different country having the different inclination angle as well as the different altitude from the Earth surface. So polar orbiting satellites called the Earth observation satellite. So which located near above the poles, and this satellite mostly use the Earth observation flight time. So sun synchronous satellite or Earth observation satellites are same. So for example, if it is that one particular satellite is crossing, for example, in resource satellite 2, Indian satellite, crossing at 9 o'clock in India, when it comes to the next orbit, for example, in Africa, the local time always maintained the same because that they are maintaining that sun shadow and other things. So few application of remote sensing. Why the remote sensing we are using, geospatial technology we are using? It is allows collection of much more data in a shorter time. For example, OCM, ocean color monitoring satellite, the entire India will be covered within 3 days. If somebody want to study about the agriculture or forest in the entire Indian subcontinent, they can able to study within 2-3 days. So vast area coverage and less time required. And if you are thinking the manpower, it's required a lot of manpower to complete the task. So different artificial intelligence and machine learning tools are available, which is supposed to extract the object-based information or program-based information or variable-based information from the satellite data. So it allows retrieval of data for a region difficult or impossible to reach. For example, especially in the mountainous region, it is hills or dense, very dense forest area, which we are not able to access or difficult to access. Then such kind of area, if you anybody want to collect it, it is easy to collect the data from remote sensing. Open ocean, hazardous terrain, high mountainous and extreme weather areas, ocean depth, and atmosphere. So these are the different layers which is helping to study the different aspect, seafloor topography, backscatters, which is microwave studies, backscatters, which is helping to identify the altitude or terrain variation, sediment thickness, geological map of seafloors. So digital imagery greatly enhanced GIS because GIS, that data source, for GIS data source, one main source for GIS is remote sensing. Directly it is used because we can able to see human eye. For example, if any flood occurs or any forest fire occurs, ISRO, the NRSE, so sister concern of ISRO, NRSE, National Remote Sensing Center, NRSE, they are providing that any natural calamities, satellite information very quickly, wherever it's occurred across the globe. Sometimes in they are maintaining India as a main, So land use, land cover changes, atmospheric emissions, especially CO2 and other greenhouse gas emission, vegetative cover and their changes, water bodies, change detection including the glacial coastline and sea levels. These are the some other application of remote sensing. So application of GIS technology, so far we have discussed about the application of remote sensing. Now we are going for the application of GIS technology. It's widely covered and a number of applications are there. Water resource management and sustainability, location-based services, transport planning, urban, rural, and land management, environment impact assessment. So these are the different kind of studies. These are the different studies we are using the GIS technology. So I would like to share the satellite images captured by CompSat 3A image 16 September 2020 and CartoSat series satellite pan image 18th of February 2020. So what this indicates, you might know about reading the different newspapers and the television. The Dabhaon power plant got damaged because of the flash flood. The left-hand side image is occurred before the event occurred. The right-hand side image is after the event. There you can able to see the 7th of February that event major rock slide and tsunami avalanches reported local place near Raini village of Chamoli district. Subsequently, what happened? The flash floods were reported in Rishiganga and Dhuliganga rivers, catchment areas, causing severe loss of life and property. The power plant at the Raini and Dabhaon suffered maximum damage in that location. So this is one kind of example. Without investigation of the field, we can able to estimate the causes of the damages and the economic losses very rapid time, as well as we can have this kind of satellite images, as well as the AI, which is supposed to take the emergency action plan, okay? Especially in the disaster situation. So now I am moving to the geospatial technology in water resource management. So in this case, I am selecting the Leh Ladakh area. This is everyone knows about the Leh Ladakh, where it is located in the northern part of India. joining with the state of JNK, Union Territory. Now, Leh and Ladakh area become the Union Territory. This is our about the Leh Valley. You can be able to see the different location. The blue color dot indicates the level, fourth level stage water distribution system, and the blue color line indicate the major streams, and red color indicate the major roads. The major road is connecting from Kardungla Pass to Leh city, and it moves towards Kargil in the left hand side, and the right hand side it goes to the Himachal Pradesh. So what is the beauty of this area? It's a cold desertic condition. Cold means what? The temperature normally varies from zero, we can say the 8 degree plus 8 degree to minus 30 degree. So summer time the temperature is 0 to 8 degree. In the winter time it goes 0 to minus 18 degree. That's why this area called cold. The desert means that this area is receives very minimum rainfall amount of less than 50 millimeter per annum. You can able to see, we are thankful to the Meteorological Department, Indian Air Force Station Leh, who provided this information to us. So you can see that 2002, the rainfall received the over the period, that entire year, 47, 2003, 47.7. So you can say that continuously, and you can able to see that in 2006 and 8-10, where that area receives more than 80 millimeter per annum. So what is the statement of the problem? The task of groundwater potential mapping becomes more complex in nature. Why? It is involves not only a single parameter, it involves many parameters, for example, rainfall, drainage, geology, and other things, and highly variable in nature the geological environment. Okay. So the identification of the groundwater potential zone using remote sensing and GIS techniques involves interpretation of different thematic maps, such as vegetation, land use, land cover, hydrogeomorphology, drainage, lithology, subsurface lithology, structure, slope, lineament density, drainage density, which have been used inferring the occurrence of groundwater. Most importantly, we are using the thickness of aquifer, depth of aquifer, groundwater level in a particular region. As an inevitable consequence, the water demand goes up and the pressure on the natural resource. Has increased exponentially because that groundwater or surface water uses extensively in the agriculture purpose, industrial purpose, as well as the domestic purpose. In such a scenario, it becomes important to delineate the groundwater potential zone in the area and identify the suitable area for artificial recharge structures. Why artificial recharge structures are important? To sustainable development of groundwater source or surface water source in a particular area. If you are extracting the too much of water from in a particular area, the groundwater going down deeper and deeper, at once upon a time it area become the arid zone. So when in that area become that dry, then it takes lot of time for aquifer replenishment. So in such kind of places, artificial groundwater recharge location is the suitable to increase a rapid aquifer replenishment in a particular region. So artificial groundwater recharge is a process by which groundwater reservoir is augmented at a rate exceeding what the cost of under natural condition of replenishment of the aquifer. So the natural infiltration of water from rainfall or precipitation or snow or melting takes little more time. Public Health Engineering Department, we have collected groundwater level, well location, and the usage of how much the water is used, has been used in the Leh city. So across the globe, there are different groundwater potential mapping methods has been used. Different statistical approach has been used. So in this study, we have used the frequency ratio model. The frequency ratio model is a bivariate statistical approach, which is used the probability of the groundwater potential area using different dependent variables and independent variables. So the what is the frequency ratio? F4, the short form of frequency ratio is called F4. W by TW whole divided by CP by TP, where FR indicates frequency ratio or groundwater potential index. After identification of the groundwater potential area, we created the validation data set. And after the validation, we make sure that that area are suitable for groundwater potential. So there are different thematic layer. One is contour. This contour map is extracted from digital elevation model. This is a drainage. The drainage of the area extracted from topo sheet as well as digital elevation model, because we want to update the model of the drainage system or drainage pattern. This is digital elevation model of the Leh city. This is FCC data overlaid with the digital elevation model. See, you can able to see this cursor. This is the Leh city. This is the Leh airport. This is 6 different features: buried slope, buried deep, buried sediment. So land use land cover map. We are having the agricultural land and plantation, built up area, mixed agriculture and built up land, riverbed, rocky terrain and wasteland, desertic region. After making this all the different thematic map, we brought into the geographical information system and we created the groundwater potential zonation mapping. So based on the frequency ratio model, we have identified where the higher values are having higher potential of groundwater, very high, 27 to 46. And we are having 5 different categories: very high, high, medium, low, very low. So very high value, very high having the high values, and very low having low values. So this is the groundwater budget of Leh Valley. Why it is important? Leh is a typical area. The residential population of the Leh is hardly 20,000 population. Because of that tourist population increases, the month of May, June, July, August, September, we called as a floating population, varies from 20,000 to 2 lakh population. Because of that, this area is facing extensive or severe groundwater scarcity. Basically, the Leh people used to have very consumption of very, very low, very less quantity. Because of the tourist population, the people are using the modern toilet system and bathroom system. They are consuming a lot of water. Because of that, this area is facing water scarcity, especially in the month of June, July, August. So we can able to see that number of tourist population month from May to September, and we can see that total water demand. We are keeping the water demand, how much people, floating people. In general, the Western countries, per person, they require 150 liter of water. But Indian condition, on in an average, we are using 75 liter per day. So in the hilly area, they are using very less quantity of water, especially in the relay area. Based on that, we made a calculation. So based on that, the demand of the groundwater, we have identified the artificial recharge structure with the help of water level elevation, spring location, surface elevation. So based on that, we have identified the seven different locations, and these all the locations where the recharge can be made through natural slope. We don't want to spend any extra electrical power or any pumping station. So natural grid, all seven locations, the groundwater aquifer has been fulfilled, or aquifer replenishment has been fulfilled. So artificial intelligence, this is about artificial intelligence in the wash. So what is the artificial intelligence? So artificial intelligence is the branch of computer applications and the science dealing with the simulation of intelligent behavior in computer using different variables. We can able to say that, especially in big data set, artificial intelligence were used. For example, if the data are, for example, the population data in the entire India, we can say more than 135 crore population. It's a big data set. Suppose somebody want to extract the age of 3 years old, we can simply write, and 3 years old kids we can able to extract. Suppose somebody want to extract the data of elderly people more than 60 years old, we can able to extract the data very simply using the artificial intelligence. So we need a huge amount of data to apply the artificial intelligence. Machine learning is part of artificial intelligence, which supports to prediction as well as modeling the particular phenomena using past study. For example, the global pandemic situation, we can able to measure from since December 2019 to till date, that is called past data. We can see the trend for last 1.5 years, how the trend is moved across the globe. With the help of this trend, using machine learning, we can able to see the prediction in future with the help of different variables, climatic condition, people's health condition, and proper measurement or cautions taken by the government, different variables. We can bring all together, we can able to take this. So I want to share these things in the wash, how we can able to utilize water and sanitation hygiene. So machine learning focuses on the development of program, the access to the data, especially the prediction and modeling. So how we can utilize AI for water resource management, AI for sanitation, AI for hygiene. So groundwater monitoring and management, surface water monitoring and management. For this, we need to deploy a lot of sensor in different locations of water resources. Either it may be the groundwater or it may be the surface water. Then automatic water distribution based on the time and duration. For example, I would like to share one example. If you are deploying so many sensors in the different location of the high altitude drainage and low altitude places, when the particular places receiving a maximum amount of rainfall, for example, flash flood. So we are having different sizes of sensor. One is measuring the water table of the riverbed. Another one is the rainfall measurement. When you bring these data, we can give that early warning system in the downstream side. That otherwise, we can be able to see the groundwater recharge location to make it proper planning for aquifer replenishment. This is part of the water resource assessment and management. So AI and ML, it will be used in the rural area as well as urban area. In the agriculture setup, we can use the drip irrigation, water quality mapping, and sewage and pollution of monitoring and management. So automatic water table measurement and big data, because water source is very, very important. For example, in developed countries, European some countries, and USA in some places, especially where I studied in Germany, that places, they are having the water table measurement in the borewell also, as well as the sewage drainage system also. If the sewage drainage system is exceed that limit, they are alarming and making the proper sanitation and hygiene in their location. Okay, that controls the flood in a particular area. So we will measure the water table from the borewell, tube well, dug well or open well, river water level, lake water level, and automatic rainfall and weather measurement and forecasting, application of AI in water budgeting and prediction. So the wash, sanitation, water quality and monitoring and warning. Why I am giving this water quality, especially in the rainy season and near to the tanneries or industrial chemical industry, they are releasing the pollutant to the groundwater or surface water. So water quality, because the hygiene and the sanitation play a major role in a particular family or household and their livelihood also. Because we have carried out some places the groundwater, the hygiene play a major role. Because when the person is affected by some diseases, their particular home or household, their economic condition is question mark. The livelihood opportunities, when there is no livelihood option. In such a kind of situation, we can able to use the AI and ML for water quality monitoring and warning. Then when your warning is important, very, very important, that helps the people to take proper measures to mitigate the problem. Sensor-based water quality checking and regular interval period, sewage water treatment and dispersal, how much capacity and estimation of the sewage water, distribution of the sewage water and treatment, ML for prediction and modeling, for solid waste management, sewage water and drainage monitoring, coordination and distribution of information among the different stakeholders, artificial intelligence and ML for hygiene. Hygiene, why it is important? I would like to give the example. Sanitation and hygiene. That Pradhan Mantri scheme is there for hygiene and sanitation. We can able to use the sensor. How many the sanitation and hygiene programs are properly utilizing in a given area? How many locations with the help locations they are appropriately using this existing infrastructure? So we can bring this geocoded or geotagged information to geographical information system. With the help of AI and ML, we can able to estimate or measure or observe where the system is existing very properly and very efficiently they are using. If they are lack of using, then this system will help us to identify the causative parameter why the people are not using. Okay, I'm just given an example.
So monitoring and prediction of the public health, epidemics and pandemic situations, update the different schemes in geospatial database. So central government schemes, monitoring the clean water, sanitation and hygiene, automatic detection of the source of pollution, water and solid waste source of pollution, prediction and modeling for the hygiene and sanitation and other health issues. So in the conclusion, we can use the geospatial technology and the AI for water source management and assessment, as well as groundwater potential mapping, sustainable development using artificial recharge structures, monitoring and forecasting of sanitation and hygiene, as well as groundwater, AI for sanitation, AI for hygiene, and what are the way forward? Very, very important. The opportunity to develop the geospatial technology and the WASH sector, monitoring and management, quick decision on WASH during disaster situation, better strategy plan for WASH, as I already told you, with the help of AI and ML, we can able to bring the big data set in the sanitation and hygiene sector to implement an appropriate plan in a given location. And we can able to continuously monitor the existing system, their functionality, and their program implementation and their progress. What are the challenges in the AI as well as the geospatial technology, which required big data set? Not only that, we required reliable information of the particular issue. And monitoring of sensor-based water level, groundwater level, sanitation, drainage station near remote regions are very, very important. Because once we deploy, that sensor must be there without harm by the animals and the humans. In some locations, especially IMD, Indian Meteorological Department, deployed so many automatic rain catch station that used to cause damaged by the human as well as the animals. So such kind of things, we have to make proper measures to withstand from such kind of natural calamity as well as the human and animal damages. Technology in 21st century, there's a lot of opportunities are there in machine learning and artificial intelligence available for rapid assessment, which can be reduce the time for decision making. Not only that, if you are using the AI, it is easy to handle the big data set. Thank you very much. Thank you one and all. I grateful to NIH and the director and scientists, those who provided me the opportunity to share my views. Thank you very much.